hockey season always consists of twists and turns, ups and downs, and the inevitable explosion of a race to the playoffs. Joe shoots and scores! Joe Thornton wins it in overtime! Around Beauchemin in alone, and he scores! What a goal! With the Olympics in the rearview mirror, the San Jose Sharks now lock in for what will be a 23-game sprint, and they'll start with an East Coast road trip that will put them to the test immediately, beginning with the Philadelphia Flyers. We welcome you live to Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, for the Sharks and the Flyers.
Sharks Hockey on Comcast Sportsnet California is brought to you by Jack in the Box. Try the new Bacon Insider at Jack in the Box. It's got bacon mixed right into the patty at participating restaurants. By Toyota. Do the math and save at your local Toyota dealer. And by Xfinity, home of the most live sports.
Time to check our Bay Alarm starting goaltenders here in Philadelphia this afternoon. Alex Stalock gets the call for Todd McClellan. His record 8-4 this season, and he will face Steve Mason, the number one man between the pipes for the Philadelphia Flyers this year. The former Calder Trophy winner, drafted originally by the Columbus Blue Jackets and now settling nicely with the Flyer. Todd McClellan, a 6-1 record against Philly. That one mark against the Sharks under McClellan came the last time the Sharks lost, when the Flyers beat them in San Jose. You saw Craig Berube there, who took over just 4 games into the season for Philadelphia, and he has certainly helped to turn them around, as the Flyers, we saw, certainly back in the picture in the postseason race in the NHL's Eastern Conference. Glad to be back after the Olympic break. Exactly 20 days since the San Jose Sharks last played. They've lost only one of their last 4 games. The Flyers have won 4 in a row. Should be a spirited matchup here this afternoon. Of course, this evening here in the Eastern Time Zone, as we look at the lineup for the San Jose Sharks, forwards and defense. And great to see the newcomers back. Logan Couture and, of course, Rafi Torres.
So Joe Pavelski moves up with a Joe Thornton and Brent Burns, Patrick Marleau, Logan Couture, Marty Havlett. And Rafi Torres in the lineup is going to be very interesting. Nieto, Manny Nieto back in, and Rafi Torres with Andrew Desjardins and Mike Brown. That's the line I would not want to play a lot of minutes against.
James Sheppard, Matt Tennyson, and Tyler Kennedy not in the lineup here for the Sharks. Brad Stewart back at home with an upper body injury. Sean Couturier, number 14 in orange and white, one of the top young centers in the NHL, out there for Philadelphia. A shot saved by Stalock. Good scoring chance there for Philadelphia. Now a little rough stuff in front of the net between Couturier and Matt Irwin, as you see the Flyers lineup revealing at the top of the screen as Philadelphia tries to get the groove back going. They probably didn't welcome the break all that much, having won 4 in a row going in.
Certainly their owner didn't. Mr. Schneider didn't welcome the break at all. Didn't welcome the Olympics. Didn't welcome his players going to the Olympics. But regardless, the Philadelphia Flyers have played very well up until the break. They, as you said, didn't get off to a great start, but now they are rolling into a playoff spot.
As we say, they've won 4 in a row. They've been terrific against Pacific Division teams this year as well. Philadelphia 8-4 against the clubs in the Sharks division, including that win over San Jose earlier this month. Shot from the right wing, and jumping up off his skates is Stalock to knock that one down as we look at our Lexus keys to today's game.
I think early in the startup, you've got to go with short, effective shifts. You got to be just as good at the end of the shift as you are at the start. And smart simplicity. What that means is you don't just dump the puck in just for the sake of dumping it in. You have to dump it in so the guys can go get it. You got to make the right play at the right time. As Jay Woodcroft, assistant coach, always talks about, when that what now scenario opens up for you, as it always does in every hockey game and every play, make the right play. The highest percentages. Go straight ahead, north-south hockey.
Andrew Desjardins to take this faceoff for the Sharks on this fourth line that includes Mike Brown and Rafi Torres, as Torres making his season debut here tonight after he was injured in the preseason in that collision with Anaheim's Emerson Edom. Now Brown for the Sharks out to the point. Cannon back to the circle, and Brown's shot goes wide. Jason Demers sends it back ahead for Desjardins. Desjardins trying to get it out to Torres. That was intercepted. And now the Flyers look to break out, but a good knockdown of the puck by Rafi Torres coming back through the middle of the ice. And now the Sharks will change up.
Well, the first shift for Rafi Torres, Mike Brown, Andrew Desjardins. They get a couple of hits in and they get a near chance.
Here's Jake Voracek for the Flyers, and a nicely timed poke check by Demers gets the puck off Voracek's stick. Back the other way, it's Marleau coming off his second consecutive gold medal performance for Team Canada at the Olympic Games. Marleau now facing Scott Hartnell, who loses the puck, and Vlasic, another gold medalist, clears it down the ice. We'll have an icing call.
Rafi Torres, what we look at for Rafi Torres is, number one, how's his speed? What's he going to be able to do? He takes a couple steps, gets a little bump in. That's what he's going to have to get used to more than anything, is this pace. But he makes the right play as he cuts right back to the middle and knocks the puck down. Will he be able to keep up to the pace? He hasn't played very many games since the Hossa suspension way back when he played for Phoenix. Only about 45, so it's going to take him a bit to get his game up to the speed.
That was a dangerous chance for Voracek. Kind of caught Stalock a little off guard. And now an offside called against the Flyers, who had five of their own Olympians go to Sochi. None of them coming back with gold. Voracek, one of those who ventured across the ocean to Russia for the Olympics. There's Berube, the head coach, a longtime tough guy here with the Flyers as a player. And now doing an admirable job behind the bench. Always tough to take over something midstream, actually early stream in this case.
Yeah.
Very rare to see a head coach fired three games into a season, but that's what happened to Laviolette. Simmons having some words out there right now with Adam Burrish, and they're barking at one another.
Well, you might see some emotion early in this game. These two teams usually don't see each other, but the Sharks aren't very happy with how they played against the Flyers when they're at SAP Center. There's a fine for me right there. So it will be interesting to see if the Sharks want to come back with a little bit of a pop in their game, a little bit more emotion.
The game was February 3rd at SAP Center. Sharks had a lead, and then it all fell apart in the third period when Philadelphia scored four unanswered goals and beat the Sharks 5-2.
10 times the Flyers have come back this year in the third period when they've been trailing, which is a franchise record. So this is a team, as we talked about in the open, does not give up. They keep pressing, and they've got some talent before. And you know what does a lot of the damage? Their power play. Their power play is very, very good.
Ironically, the last time the Sharks were here, and it's over 3 years ago, in the 2010 season, it was the other way around. The Sharks were down 4-1 going into the third. And as you may recall, they ended up winning that game in a shootout with goaltender Antero Niinimäki. Remember that night?
Wow. If I remember that night correctly, it was quite the spectacular game.
Well, Niinimäki was saved by the clock, I think, in the end of regulation in that game when a puck crossed the goal line, but milliseconds after time ran out. Of course, Niinimäki as well, a former Flyer. That was quite a contest and a great comeback by the Sharks, but they had it handed back to them by the Flyers. Let's reflect back on it. 2010 season, so really on the clock 4 years ago, but Pavelski tied it up. Here's that goal that crossed the line.
Wow.
As time expired to save the chance for the Sharks to go to the shootout, and then they won it 5-4. And It was certainly one of the memorable nights in the regular season that year.
You can't get any closer to that, to a goal being allowed or a goal being disallowed because of this clock. Amazing. Right on the edge. I didn't remember it being that close. I remember the move by Ryan Clough, though.
And we may see Ryan Clough on Sunday afternoon when the Sharks wrap up this road trip in New Jersey. Clough wasn't available when the Devils were in San Jose earlier this season. Part of a three-game trip starting here in Buffalo tomorrow. And we're on again at 3:30 Pacific with pregame against the Sabres. A puck knocked down with a high stick. We're just about 4 minutes into this one, scoreless. And Philadelphia with all three of the shots on goal so far.
Yeah, the Sharks haven't really got much going in an offensive push. And once again, Adam Birch and Wayne Simmonds chirping at each other as they're leaving the ice surface, going to the bench.
You know, we mentioned Torres and Couture coming back, but really it's almost a coming back a second time for Birch. He only played two games before the break. Then you take 20 days off, so he's still getting his legs back too. Demers, who was a little banged up before the break, played that last game when the Sharks beat Columbus, but missed three before that. Desjardins shoots one wide. Now Demers having a career year in assists. Jason is. Mike Brown picks it up on the near boards, gets it back to Demers at the line. His wrist shot gets through, and they score! Rafi Torres in his first game back, and it's 1-0 Sharks.
What you love about this play is Jason Demers at the point. First of all, retrieving the puck down low, outstanding job, low high, and then go to the net if you're Rafi Torres. But the little subtle move at the blue line by Jason Demers. What's this little juke at the blue line? Puck's gonna go low, high, Rafi Torres. A little fake, a little stop, go back the other way, quick shot towards the net, and then what do? Head to the net. Rafi Torres right from the corner, heading to the front of the net. That's where he loves to be. Puck bounces fortuitously to him, and he puts it in the net. Good start for the Sharks. That line really is the only one, is the only line that got the previous chance on the shot from Rafi earlier. But the interesting thing was the play by Jason Demers at the blue line.
Torres with a nice job to beat Michael Roffle to that rebound. Now another opportunity for the Sharks, plus a delayed penalty call coming as it's touched by the Flyers. Claude Giroux, and now we'll get a penalty against the most penalized team in the NHL.
Well, here's a great opportunity for the Sharks to get their power play going early on this push to the playoffs. Something that struggled.
32 Philadelphia, 2 minutes.
Was up and down, but really struggled before the break. And you've got a different look now. Now that Logan's in, maybe Rafi Torres will be out there as well, playing in front. Nice job by Martin Havlat to make sure that he protected the puck. And then Logan Couture getting inside, draws that high stick from strike.
So now here's an area where the Sharks can really turn this stretch drive into something special. The power play, which has been a problem, not just this year, but especially lately. 1-for-29 in their last 9 games. But of course, that was without Couture and without a much healthier lineup. We'll see if the Sharks can get it going with the man advantage here starting today in Philadelphia. Joe Thornton out there to the line. Trouble on the entry. It comes back to Boyle, and they'll regroup in the neutral zone. Now Marleau fires it in and looks for coverage on this side, intercepted by Grossman for the Flyers. Now the Sharks overload in the corner and try and get it back. Pavelski in that corner, and Boyle trying to range across, just didn't have that reach to keep it in. And a good penalty kill start so far for Philadelphia. Now Boyle with a cleaner entry to Couture. Logan for Marleau. He'll bank it around for Thornton. Joe takes it, turns, gives for Boyle. Back for Thornton. Now in front, Marleau tried the touch pass to Pavelski. Nice idea, but a good breakup by Grossman.
Good penalty killing from the Philadelphia Flyers. They've only allowed one power play goal in the 6 games before the break. They're 7th in the NHL on the penalty kill.
On the shooter, and it's Boyle. Here's Wingles, and he put it just wide. And Havlat coming through the crease was tripped up. Sharks hold the zone. Burns now to Wingles. Tommy Wingles, he was hot offensively before the break. Havlat across. Here's a shot and a save by Mason off Irwin. Matt Irwin trying to settle a bouncing puck, kept it alive. Now the Sharks recover. It is Demers. Havlat walks the goal line. Back out to Burns. Mason, the save off Brent Burns.
Great chance there. Little near side pass. You start moving behind the net, but you pass it back to that short side. And Brent Burns, Martin Havlat almost teaming up for the second goal.
Just to give you the official scoring play on Torres' goal. Of course, his first of the year in his first game. Demers and Brown, the assists at 4:25. Sharks trying to double that lead on the power play here. So far, the Flyers holding them off as strikes out of the box now, and the Sharks come up empty. But Rafi Torres, in his first game, in his first period, gives the Sharks the lead.
Rafi Torres back in the lineup. And so is the forward right choice. And the right choice is always to go to the net. Rafi Torres and his line working down low, high shot. Nice little play. A drive towards the net. You never know what you're going to pick up. But Rafi Torres picks up the shot. The puck that bounces a couple times goes off of Raffo and right to Rafi Torres into the net. First game back. First goal of the game. Nicely done by Rafi Torres, but a super play also by Jason Demers on our forward right choice.
Rafi's second career goal against the Philadelphia Flyers in 14 games in the regular season. Sharks with the lead here in the first period. Shots are even, 3 each. Steve Downey gets it across. Chance here for the Flyers. Broken up. Unable to pull the trigger. There was Matt Reed. Now Couturier trying to get it back to Reed behind the net. Matt Irwin for the Sharks. Thornton gets a stick on it. And the Flyers get it back to Nicholas Grossman. Reed trying to slow it down. That puck came out at the blue line offside.
I think the one thing about playing the Philadelphia Flyers is they're heavy along the boards, like the LA Kings, like the Anaheim Ducks, like St. Louis. And it's not an Eastern Western thing, but they play Philadelphia a lot like the Western teams that the Sharks are used to competing against all the time. They play a very heavy game.
I don't know if you want to equate it to heavy, but the Flyers, as we mentioned, lead the NHL in penalty minutes. And they did the last 2 seasons in a row before this. So it is certainly not coincidental that they play that way. It is by design. It is really part of their franchise identity. The Flyer DNA is all over this place with tributes to players like Dave the Hammer Schultz and his ilk.
Did you see that? Before the game. That's guys fighting like crazy, and Dave Schultz losing his marbles, and the fans are loving every minute. Can you imagine if this team was like the lowest penalized team in the league? The fans here, they don't want that, right? They want this team to be rough and tough Broad Street bullies.
A little raw meat before the game up on the Jumbotron just to get everybody fired up here. Face off in the Shark zone with San Jose in front on the Torres goal. What a great start for Rafi Torres as Matt Nieto gets it ahead. Now Burrish 2-on-1 with Wingles. Adam Burrish trying to dangle, couldn't. Now he tries to feed Wingles, can't. And it's taken back by Simmons.
Good defensive play by Andre Mazaros.
Nieto forces that to the front. Now Burrish gives it back to him. Nieto turns away from Simmons. Vlasic from the line, and that goes high and wide. Boyle, and they keep it in. Wingles again. Out to the line, off the foot of Vlasic, and Simmons will just move it past Marlowe and out of the zone. Good jump to the Sharks here since that goal. Now Marlowe, he's got Couture. A little behind Logan as it was partially blocked on its way through. Hard pass intended for Havlat. That goes all the way to Voracek for the Flyers. They attack in 3-on-2 formation, broken up nicely on the defensive end by the Sharks. Marlowe gains the zone, feeds to Demers, who bursts to the net. Just off his stick, but he recovers it, and back to Marlowe. A quick shot that skips wide off a deflection. And Giroux now for the Flyers, will control and shovel it ahead. Havlat, rink wide, and it's Scott Hannon alone down the wing, working against the Flyers. And now it's a shot from Brown that's saved by Mason. And here's the line that scored the goal. And they've been a good line so far in this first period. Desjardins with Torres. Andrew Desjardins battling Giroux. Desjardins comes out of the corner, tries to force it in short side. Back to him and back to Torres. Rafi can't get past Braden Colburn, who gives him a shove. Now Torres on the near side. They try to get it up top for Brown, but it's brought out again by the Flyers. Adam Hall shovels it through center past Irwin, and Desjardins all the way back defensively. Boy, that's a good shift for that line again.
That's a really nice play by Andrew Desjardins, too, and a good release by Justin Braun to support Andrew Desjardins, who just bumped it behind the net and broke the puck out.
Now Thornton line on. Burns fires. That's blocked by Hall and cleared out by Ronaldo for Philly.
That's the other guy you want to see get on the scoreboard is Brent Burns.
Dan Boyle, he could use a goal. Thornton picks it up out of the corner. Back to Vlasic. One-timer tipped by Burns just wide. Nice play as Matt Reed tries to control, does behind the net. Now up the far side, Grossman tangling with Burns as Vlasic keeps it away from the pressuring Sean Couturier. Wingles in for Burrish. Trying to drop it back for Tommy. Intercepted by the Flyers. He'll come ahead through center. Reed drops it. Mazzaro skates in. Nice save by Stalock. But they score. Andre Mazzaro ties the game.
Not a well-sorted-out back check by the Sharks. Look, they're all in the line. They all get behind on the wrong side of the puck, and Andre Mazzaro steps in, gets the shot, stays with it. Nobody picks him up. Again, shoot the puck, go to the net. End of the entry into the zone. It's a crossing play, and then you've got to start to talk and organize. Everybody's okay except the last back checker into the zone. Didn't get all the way over and pick up his man.
Downey will get the primary assist as his little shovel pass got it back to Mazzaro, and we're all tied up here in the first period. 1-1 the score. Mazzaro's fifth of the year from Downey and Reed at 10:36. And here come the Flyers again. Simmons over the line. A shot from LeCavalier, and Stalock with the save. And the puck's in the net, and it's 2-1. Wow, what a shift by the Flyers to come right back and take the lead.
Braden Schenn, kid from Saskatoon, puck just bounces out wide. Everybody drives towards the net, and this is just a fluke play. Unfortunately, Jason Demers has the puck bank off of his skate as Braden Schenn's just trying to center it. This goal is going to count without a doubt. The net came off well after as Jason Demers pushed it off after he was just bumped into by Wayne Simmons, but the puck, I do believe, had already crossed the line.
The goals come 22 seconds apart, and Philadelphia turns the deficit into a lead. They will review it.
Yes, this is a good goal. It's a bad goal against the Sharks, but it's a good goal as far as the NHL will be concerned. They'll count it. This is just Braden Schenn just trying to center the puck, and Jason Demers coming to the back, or coming to the forepost, the strong side post, and just an unfortunate bounce. So what do you have to do? You got to bounce yourself back. There you go. It's an unfortunate set of circumstances. And Wayne Simmons is there as well. That's who Braden Schenn was looking for, was Wayne Simmons. And he gets his 16th goal of the season. And the Sharks are all of a sudden down by two.
Well, if this looks a little bit familiar, in a sense it is. In that four-goal third period in San Jose back on February the 3rd, the Flyers scored twice in a minute 18, three times in 2:45 to take that game over as Stalock stops this Zach Ronaldo shot. Two quickies by Philly. They lead it 2-1.
This is why you need active defense. They're going to jump up in the play. Go ahead and roll this, guys. As everybody starts rolling up in the play, Andre Mazzaro is going to jump in. Coming in late. Sorry, I had the wrong guy. Coming in late, Mazzaro is there, and he just stays with it. Gets the shot on net. Alex Stalock is aggressive, maybe over-aggressive there, and Mazzaro just stays and gets the job done. When you're having that type of movement entering the zone, you really have to communicate, defensemen and forwards, to make sure you pick the right guy.
Braden Schenn had been a little cold until the last game before the Olympics when he scored in a 2-1 win over Calgary, and now he gets another one here this evening against the Sharks. The goal that puts them ahead, 2-1, Philly. Shen's 16th from Le Cavalier and 7th.
Coaches will be particularly upset about that first goal because the Sharks had the puck in the offensive zone and weren't able to keep it in. In fact, it got out quite easily and allowed that transition game to get going.
Icing called here, much to the disappointment of the gathered here at Wells Fargo Center in Philadelphia.
Craig Berube asking the referee about it, but probably doesn't get an explanation that he likes.
You mentioned Shen's 16th goal. The Flyers have 7 players in double digits in goal scoring, so their offense has been pretty balanced from that regard, and it's awfully hard to shut down just a line and shut down the Flyers. Of course, they didn't start the season off very well, especially their top offensive player, Claude Giroux, but he's come to form recently as well. But his poor start probably cost him closer consideration for Team Canada on the Olympic squad. Now Couturier, and the Flyers have it again. Mazaros with a wrist shot that's blocked. Boyle ahead for Thornton. Now Joe, poke checked away by Mazaros, but Pavelski's able to wrist it in. Mazaros, formerly an Ottawa Senator, originally in his NHL career. He went to Sochi for Slovakia, did not medal. As Vlasic will chase back, icing waved off.
Really? Guy from behind his own net shoots it all the way down the ice. I guess Mark Edward Vlasic didn't make a good enough turn to go get the puck.
Now Gustafson for Philadelphia. Good read by Nieto to intercept, and Demers slides it across for Scott Hannon. Hannon, he had it going offensively before the break, Scott did. 3 assists in the last 2 games before the 20-day layoff. Here's Demers back for Marleau. From the point, his shot wide. Now Hannon plays it back behind the net for Havlat. Marty Havlat all the way up top. Leaving it for Hannon. And back down for Logan Couture. He's wrapped up down there by Gustafson. Digs it out. Havlat taps it to Hannon, up to Demers. Jason pass, gets it back, and the one-timer just healed it a little bit. Now Hannon, he'll walk the line and give it to Demers. Jason with the assist on the only Sharks goal, and he can't punch it by Braden Shen.
Jason Demers has been very active in this game. Offensively, he's jumping in, he's getting open. Made the one goal happen. Unfortunately, he's on for the other one. The ones against, but he has been very active and on his toes to start this game.
Sharks turn it over to the neutral zone. Now Voracek stumbles. Flyers with a chance here. Giroux's shot went wide as lunging over to that side was Stalock.
Alex is being aggressive, but I think he's just got to calm himself down a little bit. That says something that you'll come back in. You want to play well, so you're being a little bit maybe over-aggressive because you have to read those boards. It's like they're like Calgary boards. They jump right off the end. You're going to get caught on that.
We'll take a break. 2-1, Flyers in front. Time for tonight's McDonald's True Stories. We flashback. 2 Sharks scored their first career goals against Philadelphia. That is the Florida Panthers' Dan Boyle. His first NHL goal scored back in 1999 against the Flyers. And that is Joe Thornton in his rookie year, beating Garth Snow in 1997. Boiler beating John Van Beesbrouck. And interestingly for Joe Thornton, he scored his first NHL goal against the Flyers, and he hasn't scored against Philadelphia since his last goal as a Bruin. That was back in 2005, just about a week before the trade.
I asked both guys about their goals. Dan Boyle described it to a T. That exactly, and you just saw how he did it. Joe Thornton said to me, he said, I don't know, I think I was like, I was just standing in front and went off my skater. It might have been a tip-in. I don't know, I can't remember.
How about that video of Dan Boyle, the baby-faced Dan Boyle? Yeah. That was back when he was good-looking. Shot comes from Couturier, tipped up into the screen and out of play.
You're looking at me expecting me to comment on that. Are you kidding me?
There's Joe Thornton. course, nobody forgets their first NHL goal, as you said. It is permanently imprinted in your mind.
I forgot he wore number six.
Yeah?
Yeah, I forgot he wore number six in Boston when he first started out.
Of course, Joe went quite a while before he got that first goal. In fact, the streak of games starting his career leading up to that first goal is his longest goalless streak ever. Ever since then, it's never been as big an issue. Well, if you enjoyed watching the Sharks in Sochi, be sure to welcome them back on March 4th against Carolina at SAP Center. Everybody in attendance will get an exclusive commemorative Sharks in Sochi poster. And get your tickets for that game now at sjsharks.com. Justin Braun with a shot, and that one's out of play. Faceoff will stay inside. It was deflected out of the zone by a flyer. You see one of the Sharks' four Olympians there, Joe Pavelski, who says he really enjoyed his experience in Sochi, even though the United States did not medal and lost that bronze medal game 5-0 to the Finns. But Pavelski said it was a great experience. Of course, I'm going to guess it paled in comparison to playing for the gold medal in Vancouver.
How about Teemu Selänne, though?
What a terrific
tournament. Is that great or what? Terrific tournament. Fantastic MVP of the tournament. A nice way to go out, so to speak, in your Olympic career.
He only played in six.
Amazing. Absolutely amazing.
Flyers lead a 2-1. They're out shooting the Sharks 9-4. And they've really controlled the offensive flow of play here since the Sharks' goal by Rafi Torres. Here's Boyle, ahead for Wingles, and that's intercepted by Luke Shen and cleared out to center. Boyle again, this time a short give for Wingles. Off his stick and into the corner, he battles Gustafson. Played ahead by Mark Streit, and now Simmons scampers through center ice and into the Sharks' zone. Maneuvers around Vlasic, who pins him up against the boards. Stalock out to play this, and he risks it perfectly to Marlowe.
That's the added element of Alex Stalock playing goal for you, as he moves the puck extremely well.
Mazaros, and he gives it away. Couture looks out front. He had Marlowe there, but Mazaros recovered to intercept.
All orange jerseys inside that slot area.
Sharks will get a line change as Streit takes his time coming through the middle, and Mike Brown lays the body on Mark Streit, and that'll be an offside whistle against the Flyers.
I think one of the things that you're looking at too with Mike Brown and James Shepherd and guys like that, they're auditioning for a permanent role in that third or fourth line right now. Tom McClellan really doesn't know what he's got coming back. Doug Wilson's talked about how he wanted to build a team and how he built a team from last year, but he really hasn't been fair to even look at what's been going on with the Sharks, because it hasn't been the team that Doug Wilson built and designed. So there's a lot of guys auditioning for their roles right now in this playoff stretch, this playoff run, and to get to be a solid 100%, I'm going to be on this line every playoff game.
Hannon turning just in time to get the puck back for the Sharks, who are fighting a strong forecheck here by the Flyers, trying to get out of the zone. Top line on for Philly, and Grossman's shot from the point is blocked, but Voracek back on it. He goes across looking for Giroux, broken up by Hannon. Now Giroux to Grossman. Grossman to the other side, taken nicely off his skate by Colburn. Back behind the net is Scott Hartnell. Hartnell back to the point. Colburn keeps his feet moving, dishing back to the boards for Hartnell. In front is Voracek, wraps it around. A dangerous area there. Nobody in orange able to get to it, but now Colburn holds the zone. Demers will have a chance here to play it up to a forward. He does to Desjardins, and now he'll skate it out.
Nice little pop-up by Demers. He just found Andrew Desjardins in the face-off circle.
Philly, not what you'd say overly dominant at home this year. 16-10-1 on home ice. Sharks road record 15-12-3. It's Thornton. Referee trying to get out of the way. Irwin shot, tip saved, and it's a high touch, so it's going to come out of the zone. But still, a nice save, even though it wouldn't have counted by the Flyers goaltender.
And that's the first time that the Sharks have had the pressure, as small as it was, in the Flyers zone. As you said, after the Sharks scored their power play, their goal with Rafi Torres, things got going the other way for the Philadelphia Flyers, and they've controlled this pace in this game in this first period.
2.5 to go here in the opening stanza. As it's wristed around by Mason. Sharks trying to hold it in. Braun toward the front of the net. Pavelski wheels it around. Thornton got a piece of it, but the Flyers come out. It's Downey at center. He'll lay it in for Matt Reed. Tracked down by Braun, who got position. Gets to the puck first. Supported by Burns. Now Pavelski takes it nicely to Irwin. And on to Joe Thornton. The captain comes across center, recognizing the line change in progress. That was almost a suicide pass to Tommy Wingles. Wingles gets it back. Trying to put it on net, but he missed. Burrish glances by Simmons, and he gets a penalty.
Yeah, hands got up high on the head.
Simmons was going to turn and maybe retaliate, but then he saw the referee's arm up. And now as it's intercepted, we get the penalty to Adam Burrish.
Just a brush by Adam Burrish. Just getting his hands up, his elbow up a little bit, and that's going to be garnering the call.
San Jose number 37, 2 minutes roughing.
Roughing, okay. He's coming across, going after Wayne Simmons. The guy's been going at it. Elevated himself a bit there, so the Sharks on the penalty kill, and this has been a very good power play. Before the break, they scored an 8 of 9 games. In fact, they had an 8-game power play goal-scoring streak.
26% of Philly's goals this year have come on the power play. That's the most of any team except Washington. And after Stalock's save, Voracek shoots it high. Giroux back to the line. Blocked in front by Braun. Voracek trying to keep it going. Here's Couture. He's 2-on-1 with Marleau. Speed and skill together. Couture shoots and off the crossbar as the Sharks get close to a shorthanded tying goal.
Yeah, Logan Couture. I like to see him shoot. You want to see those guys get the puck on the net, especially in a shorthanded situation.
I'm not sure if Mason touched that with his glove, too, but it looked like it came off the crossbar from our vantage point high up here in the press box at Wells Fargo Center.
You got that right.
Now the Flyers trying to get going on the power play, and they do. Braden Schenn and the pass to Le Cavalier, not a clean one, but kept in at the point. Now Giroux, and that's got Hannon sending it down as we're down to half a minute here in this opening period. So there will be carryover into the second if the Sharks kill the rest of this time here in the first. Taken by Le Cavalier. He battles fellow Quebecer, Marc-Edouard Vlasic. And golfed out by Braun and down, and that's going to do it for the first period here as time's going to run out. And the Philadelphia Flyers will carry power play time into the second period of 24 seconds. They held the Sharks without a shot, the Flyers did, through almost the final 11 minutes of that opening period. That is it for period one here in Philadelphia. Stick around. We'll check in briefly with Brody Brazil and Brett Hedekin in our Sportsnet Central studios. And then Drew will be back here to talk to the Sharks' Rafi Torres.
Sharks Hockey on Comcast Sportsnet California is brought to you by Esurance. Insurance for the modern world. See how much you could save on car insurance at esurance.com.
And back in Philadelphia as we get ready to start the second period with the Flyers ahead 2-1. Time for our Geico quote of the game, and it is from Rafi Torres, tonight playing in his first game of the season. And he said, quote, "It was good to hear from the general manager to come in and just go out and play hockey." Something that Rafi Torres said he's heard from Sharks management from the day they acquired him from the Phoenix Coyotes for a draft pick in that trade last year at the deadline.
You have to know what you have in a player. And a guy like Rafi Torres, you know what he brings. He plays on the edge, but he brings emotion and intensity, a physical play that helps make the other guys on your team a little bit bigger as well, play a little bit harder, play a little bit bigger, play more physical. Rafi Torres, Doug Wilson said from the get-go, doesn't want him to change, wants to play his game, play as hard as he can, as physical as he can, and continue to try to intimidate his opponents through that tough, hard play.
There is no question when Rafi Torres is on the ice, he is noticed.
Absolutely.
By the opposition. Right. Craig Berube probably had a little bit of Rafi Torres in his DNA back in the day as a Philadelphia Flyer as well. Sharks have a little bit of penalty killing work to do here. 24 seconds left in the Philadelphia power play to start this second period. That's the carryover of the Adam Burrish penalty. Sharks will be looking to get some more pucks to the net too. Only five in that first period. None from the top line. Burns, Pavelski and Thornton all kept off the shot sheet in that first period. Flyers tail end of the power play. Mazzaros and Stalock slides across to make a big save. And now the penalty's over as Burrish is out of the box. Puck came toward him, but he couldn't corral it. And the Sharks are called for icing.
Wow, you have to look at that save as a huge save early in the period. That would have been 3-1, so why not give Alex Stalock our bail arm save of the game? Look at this push across, and not only that, right away he is able to get his eyes over and find the puck quickly because the puck's coming back the other side from Mazzaros. Alex makes a beautiful save for our bail arm save of the game.
Off the faceoff win by Philadelphia, the Sharks will clear it now up to center ice. Back at full and even strength here, early second period. Down 2-1 on first period goals by Andre Mazzaros and Braden Schenn, and Rafi Torres with the only goal for San Jose. Burrish guides it in. Sharks will change up after the penalty kill. Try and get their line rotations back the way they want them. Flyers come in. Downey a wrist shot, and Stalock squeezes the pads together to make that save. But the Flyers keep putting shots on net. That's 12 now to the Sharks' 5.
Interesting, Alex Stalock gets a start over Antti Niemi. The Sharks' last game against the Philadelphia Flyers, we talked about 4 goals in the third period. The coaches were not happy with the way that the team played. They weren't happy with the way that Antti Niemi played. They weren't happy about much. So Alex Stalock getting the start is a nice move by Todd McClellan, I think, coming back with Antti Niemi off the Olympics.
Niemi gave up 3 goals on 4 shots during a 2-minute-and-45-second span in that third period earlier in the month against the Flyers, and that game came apart for the Sharks. And in talking to McClellan in the days leading up to this game, he said that even though Niemi didn't play for Finland over in Sochi as the third goalie, because he was the goalie giving work to guys after the regulars went off at practice, he may have in fact seen more shots than if he would have played in the games. So there was some concern to give him a little bit of extra rest. Of course, the time change with the travel, etc. And don't be stunned if you see Niemi tomorrow night against Buffalo. I would say it's a pretty good bet. Desjardins sends it in as Simmons gets back for Philadelphia. Wayne Simmons having a terrific year, 42 points, including 18 goals. Here's a chance for Couturier, draws a penalty. He couldn't slide it in that open side, but the Flyers will go back on the power play with the hooking call coming.
Long pass on the stretch. Just keep your eye on, go ahead and just roll this forward. Just keep your eye on the top of the screen, gang. Wayne Simmons head up all the way. Voracek just cuts in the middle. Sharks D don't respond properly coming onto the ice on the change. Dan Boyle looking up at the big screen, making sure that the right call was made. But again, the Flyers looking quicker, looking sharper, executing better right now than the Sharks.
2:07, time of the hooking penalty to Dan Boyle. Second power play in a row for Philadelphia. Voracek shoots one that deflects high. Philadelphia 0-1. They had 2 shots, 2 scoring chances on their earlier power play that carried on to the beginning of this period. There's a shot knocked down with his blocker by Stalock. Giroux back for Simmons. And up top on his backhand is Voracek. Gets it back. Now onto the line. Strike couldn't keep it in as Marleau touched that, and it forced the puck out of the zone.
So the Flyers will change on that power play. And for the defense, it's not a bad change to get because you get rid of Wayne Simmons and Scott Hartnell, who play very tough in front. And guys like Mark Streit shooting the puck.
Simmons has 9 power play goals right this year of his 18.
And now you've got a different little bit look of the line. This is a power play unit that likes a little bit of a down and low play, or down and in play, I should say, which for Braden Schenn off the post.
So the second unit on for Philadelphia, Shen over to Couturier, number 14 on that far side. Here is Couturier, down for Downey, and he gives it back. Mazzaros, who has one of the two goals. Le Cavalier shoots it wide.
Oh yeah, there's that guy coming off the boards too. Left-handed shooter.
Been cold, only three in his last 26, and this one's blocked by Couture. That was Le Cavalier I meant, with three goals in 26 coming in. Mazzaros. Back over to Couturier. He'll load up, and that's deflected just wide. Stalek may have got a piece of it.
I think Braden Shen was the guy that did go deflect the puck. Nicely done by Braden in front. Just keeps his stick loose and just moves to the puck. Knocked it down just wide.
Changes on both sides here. Under half a minute on the power play. Fired in by Adam Hall. And now Burrish comes across, but he's forced off the puck. Drew a penalty. A tripping call against the Flyers. That'll end the power play. And in 19 seconds, the Sharks will go on one.
There's some 4-on-4. Adam Burrish comes across. You see his legs get tangled a little bit.
Michael Raffle,
yeah. Raffle was trying to play hard off the pads, and his stick got in the back of the legs of Adam Burrish. And Burrish flew into the boards.
3:48, time of the Raffle minor, so a little 4-on-4 play. And then we'll have a man advantage for the Sharks. Pavelski gets it back. Here's Braun, one-timer, glove save, and a nice one at that by the Flyers netminder Steve Mason.
I want to get back in the game and start controlling the puck. How do you control the puck? You got to win the draw. And right off the drop, bang, here comes the shot. Chance. Mason found that. The Sharks, Joe Thornton, not able to get to the front of the net right away on Mason.
Probably going wide on a second angle there from the camera behind the net.
Good goalies, though. They want to control the play, right?
On the draw, Colburn intercepts the backhander by Thornton. Couturier rubbed out by Irwin. Thornton brings it out of the zone to center for Pavelski as the Sharks now get ready to go on the power play. Dan Boyle likely to stay on here and join the group on the 5-on-4, and he does. Sharks 0 for 1 on the power play so far. Two shots counting as scoring chances in the first period attempt as Marleau has it in the faceoff circle. Plays it in front, Pavelski, and he scores! Lovely feed and a great move. And it's 2-2.
How easy did Joe Pavelski make that look? Patrick Marleau gets it up top. Now he's going to start walking towards the net. Now he forces a decision. What do you do if you're the defenseman? You got to play it like a 2-on-1, and then you've got to start to collapse because you got Joe Thornton coming in the weak side. So the D's got to stay at home, let the goalie handle the shooter. Joe Pavelski gets his 30th goal of the season and makes it look easy. What a nice play that was. Downey got out a little bit high, and he had to try to collapse back. By that time, Joe Pavelski had it in. And boy, that's a good power play goal and a big goal for the Sharks to get back even in this game.
Well, the way it's been going, any power play goal for the Sharks is a good power play goal. Now they've got a chance again here on the attack. Back to 5-on-5. It's Boyle. And that'll go off the stick of the Flyers. Number 26, Gustafson, and ahead now to Giroux. Giroux hands it off for Voracek, and he can't quite handle that pass. Hartnell back for Voracek. He tries to swing it around, but lost his balance. Havlat up to center, out of the reach of Couture, and a good regroup by the Flyers. Here's Hartnell, loads up, trying to give it to the trailer Giroux, but it was in his feet. Things opening up here as Marleau skates to center. He'll gain the zone, brings it wide to the near board. Bumped by Luke Shen, and Giroux coughs it up. Gave it to Wingles. Tommy Wingles dangles, shoots, turning his Burrish, puts it on net, and saved there by Mason. And now it's cleared down by Philadelphia. Quickly, the re-entry. Wingles again, fires. Didn't get a good shot away, and Nieto couldn't pick it up cleanly off the boards, but Wingles battles and keeps it alive. Flicks it back to Demers. Jason's shot tip saved by Mason. Nieto back for Wingles, and that's blocked in front. Nieto trying to reach Demers. He split the defense with that pass as Stalock aggressively out to play it back to the San Jose blue liner, Jason Demers. The scoring play, Joe Pavelski's 30th. From Patrick Marleau and Dan Boyle on the power play at 4:23, and this is offside. The big Pavelski with a big 30th goal to tie the score here in Philly.
Time to go above and beyond with Land Rover, and Joe Pavelski does all the work. But why does Braden Coburn stay where he is? Because Joe Thornton starts to walk in. So Braden Coburn in front from the Philadelphia Flyers has to play it like a 2-on-1. Go ahead and roll, guys, as Patrick Marleau starts to roll towards the net. Day Steve Downey gets a little high, a little pass down low. Now Coburn's got to back up, and by the time that Joe Pavelski gets that puck right there, he's going to put it in, because that move by Joe Thornton towards net, got to play it like a 2-on-1, and Joe Pavelski finishes it off beautifully.
Here's Burns trying to get a good bounce, and he almost did, but a good recovery back on the blue line by Philadelphia's Nicholas Grossman. Now Irwin trying to clean things up here, but Downey's got it again for the Flyers. Coburn, number 5. To Downey. Couturier left it go to the corner. Irwin plays it up. It hits Thornton in the shoulder. Go try to muscle it out. Can't. Downey digs in. Gets it back for a moment. Now he and Thornton work the boards. Couturier now working against Irwin. Tie game here in the second period. We're almost 7 minutes in. Out of the scrum, Burns will give it to Pavelski behind the Sharks' net.
That is beautiful right there. I know you're looking at it and go, what are you talking about? Beautiful. What guy's scrumming in the corner and push your puck out? But it's a well-done shrink and outnumbering people inside, winning that battle of the puck and getting it out of the zone. Really well done by the Sharks.
Couture couldn't handle Marleau's pass. Back comes Philadelphia. Couturier to Simmons. Back for him. And Couturier wasn't deep enough to receive that pass. Havlat, a nice give for Marleau. Pulls up, fires it, blocked by the Flyers. Here's Vlasic with time, and he hits the post. Boyle back for Marleau. Sharks trying to get the lead here. Couture's shot tipped in front by Havlat and recovered again. Boyle, Marleau, and he missed wide. Boy, that was right in his wheelhouse, too.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking.
Havlat releases from out front. Mazaros gets it. And now Simmons 2-on-1. Here's Simmons. The pass to Strike. Shot saved by Stalock.
Nice move across by Stalock. Stayed up. Didn't get too aggressive. He was out, but not too much.
Simmons again. Now Ronaldo offside for Philadelphia.
He was. Let's go back to the post on the big shot by Mark Edward Vlasic. Get the puck down. Get it out to the point. Mark Eberbass has got all the time in the world. Loves to get that shot through. Bang, off the post slash crossbar. Head up all the way. And Mark Eberbass, I talked to Mark Edward just before the game. Asked him how he feels, you know, coming back from Sochi. Said he felt great. You know, he's able to come get home for a short visit. But he was here a couple days earlier than the team, so he feels just fine.
And talking about his experience in Sochi, he said, forget what you might have heard, read about, especially early in the Olympics. He said the facilities for the players were great. His wife and family, his parents were there as well in Russia. He said they had a wonderful experience as well, enjoyed the entire Olympic event. But it was just great. Of course, when you come back with a gold medal, whatever might have gone wrong, you tend to forget about, probably.
Nice play here by Mike Brown on the forecheck.
Here's Torres. And that one will get by Vlasic. I think Raffy was trying to get that back to Mike Brown. Now in off Nieto's stick. Back to center Demers. And he'll get it deep. Sharks will get a quick change here. They've tied the score 2-2. Only 9 San Jose Sharks as we're getting close to the halfway point in this game. 13 shots for the Flyers. Joe Pavelski's second career 30-goal year. 2 years ago, he scored 31. That's his career high. And you got to think he's going to go well past that the way the puck's been going in the net for number 8 this year.
Stop by Matt Irwin to use the net and gain himself some space for that breakout.
Good work by Wingles, and he almost got it off Strike. Giroux now for Philadelphia. Gets it deep. Has Hartnell going after the puck against Braun. Here's Voracek. He darts in. gets it back to the line. Now across for Strike. The one-timer flutters through, hits a man in front. Voracek on his backhand. He's got Giroux and Hartnell, too, but it goes by both. Hartnell up at the line. He'll send it ahead on a tip play for Giroux. Back to Hartnell. He leans into one. Stalock blocked it, and Wingles clears it.
Good pressure by the Flyers.
That one went off the glass and out of play. As we mentioned, 30 goals for Pavelski tonight. There are your career 30 goal scorers in Sharks history. Patrick Marleau, the all-time leader in every offensive category as a Shark with six of them. And Pavelski joins a good-looking group there. Owen Nolan, Jonathan Chichu, and Logan Couture.
That's multiple 30-goal seasons. Who is the first 30-goal scorer for the San Jose Sharks in a season?
I will have to look at that list and say it was Owen Nolan.
No.
Only did it once?
Only did it one time.
Pat Ballou.
No.
I give up.
Sergei Makarov.
Ah, very good. Vlasic, they score! Tipped it in, and it's 3-2.
And it's career tying high, goal 31. And just right away, they counted this a goal. Now, they'll probably look at it and see if this was a high stick knocking the puck into the net with Joe Pavelski's puck or a stick over the crossbar, but I don't think so. When you look at this, it's a giveaway by... No, beautiful. A giveaway by the Philadelphia Flyers. Well done by Joe Pavelski. He has got exceptional eye-hand coordination. And bang, the Sharks have taken the lead now on their 10th shot.
So Pavelski ties his career high with consecutive goals here in the second period. And the Sharks, who lost the lead, now have it back 3-2. This is still pending review, but I don't think there's any question that one's good.
Yeah, it'll be a good goal. Yes. And the Philadelphia Flyers will be looking at this and going, you know, you've got full control of the puck. And these are the type of things that drive coaches crazy. You've got full control of the puck. You give it away, and there's a quick shot back on the net. Joe Pavelski gets in. Bang. Look at that. Beautifully done by Joe Pavelski.
After review, the call on the ice stands.
It definitely
goal.
Stands. It's in. It's out. And the Sharks take the lead 3-2.
Pavelski's stick might have been crossbar high when he began his motion down, but where he touched the puck, it was certainly well below the crossbar. And the Sharks have the lead 3-2 in a very entertaining game here in Philadelphia as we're halfway through the second.
If you watch Joe Pavelski, though, in a warm-up or in practice, he practices stuff like that. He'll just knock pucks down all day long after practice. Guys will just be flipping them at him, and he'll just be knocking them down.
Vlasic with the only assist at 10-12, and now he comes across center. Puts it on net, and it's saved by Mason. The big Pavelski having a big period here in Philly. Sharks with a 3-2 lead. Well, Joe Pavelski with two goals here in Philadelphia tonight. Coming off a good preliminary round with Team USA in the Olympics. Pavelski, with that goal against Russia, ended up with 4 points in the tournament, 3 assists as well. Was the second star against the Russians in what was maybe the best game for Team USA. But unfortunately, came back without a medal.
Wow. What Joe Pavelski proved once again with his play in the Olympics and his play this season so far is that he's a world-class player. He's an elite-level player. You can put Joe Pavelski on the top line as a winger. You can put him on your second line or third line as a center, and he will excel. Todd McClellan talked about it because it's the way he approaches the game as a professional, gets himself ready. He's always in great shape, but his hockey IQ is really what carries him over the top and makes him world-class.
Off the charts. One-timer by Marleau. Stop, drop, score! Logan Couture, he's back! It's 4-2!
It looks like you're going to have a change in goaltending as Steve Mason's going to come out. Ray Emery's going to come in as Logan Couture gets the Sharks' fourth goal. Again, go to the net, but a face-off win. Face-off win by Logan Couture, and he goes right to the net. A shot bounces off the glove of Mason. Logan Couture waits for it, finds it. Poise in front of the net. Just look for it. Just relax. Find the puck and bang, it does. It lands right down in a fortuitous place again for Logan Couture. And bang, it's in the net. The Sharks take the 4-2 lead. And we've got a goaltender change coming in as Ray Emery comes in for Steve Mason. As you mentioned, Randy had been playing lights out for the Flyers until, well, this second period.
Logan Couture, who missed 16 games with an upper body injury, makes it 4-2, chases Mason. There's Logan. That's his 15th goal of the year. And you get two guys back in the first game after the break, Torres and Couture, and you get goals from both of them, and you couldn't script it any better. So now the Sharks, with a 4-2 lead, they started this period trailing. A lot of hockey left, though, and we've seen both these teams when playing one another with the ability to score early and often and late and often. Here's Pavelski, wants Burns. Burns will slide it back down the boards. And battling with Cannon, he's going to draw a penalty. Voracek gives it away, and we'll get a Philadelphia power play. Scott Hannon's going to go.
Battling with the stick as much as he can. Trying to keep the puck in. He was pitching down along the wall, and Fred Burns was up at the blue line, fired it deep, and now it's just a battle for the puck. It's just hacking at the stick and working the chop through the stick to the feet, no doubt about that one.
Back to the Sharks scoring play. It was Couture's 15. Marleau and Demers with the assist, so that's 2 points each for Marleau and Demers in the hockey game, but right now the Sharks need a penalty kill. They're ahead 4-2, but the Flyers on their third power play. Simmons in front, and he mishandled that pass. Gets it back. Now the Flyers attacking from the far boards. Giroux shot in for Simmons, who tips it high and up out of play.
And there's Simmons knocks down Justin Braun.
Well after the whistle.
Now, just, I might as well get back into the swing of things.
I hear it.
Explain to me how that's not a penalty. How is that not a roughing?
It's Philly, man.
Yeah, we're in Philly, but do the rules change? How is this not a roughing play? Mind-boggling to me. It's not that we misinterpret a rule. It's just that now we're just going to ignore that.
Slapped down by Vlasic as Emery settles it behind the Philadelphia net. We've had a goaltending change here in the second period. A shorthanded chance here and along the goal line. And the net comes off, and there's going to be a Philadelphia penalty.
Chance.
It may go to Hartnell.
Philadelphia number 19, 2 minutes delay of game.
It's delay of game to Scott Hartnell for knocking the net off intentionally.
Good job again. Down low. There's the one chance. Second chance. Scotty Hartnell. He's an author now, by the way, Scott Hartnell. But that one, there's really no doubt about when he backs into that net and pushes it off. Not as sneaky as he thought he was.
So that'll put us to 4-on-4 here, as there was no question that Hartnell made no attempt whatsoever to stop and avoid the goalpost. So that wipes out the power play for Philadelphia.
One of the great characters in the NHL, and one of the best all-round guys you're ever going to meet, Scotty Hartnell.
There's a shot and a save by Emery off Boyle, who almost scored. What a quick release by Dan Boyle there, right off the faceoff.
Another good faceoff win by the Sharks. Win it back, Patrick Marleau. Boy, Ray Emery really had to react quick. I don't think he saw that till the
No.
last.
Came out of a screen, didn't it?
Yep.
Now Braden Schenn around, and Strike can't handle it. Back to Marleau. 4-on-4 here in the second period, with the Sharks having exploded for 3 unanswered goals to take their biggest lead of the game so far, 4-2. Schenn across center. Gives it to Le Cavalier, and he fumbled it. Boyle will slide it down the board. This might be icing, and it will be. Sharks will have a power play of their own, more penalties notwithstanding, in 50 seconds. Back-to-backs to start the post-Olympic schedule for the Sharks. We're in Buffalo tomorrow. Join us at 3:30 pregame live with Brody and the crew. And then the play-by-play at 4 Pacific. Here's Grossman walks in. Dangerous play in front. Cleaned up by Martin Havlat.
A couple of amazing wins by the Buffalo Sabres their last two games.
Yeah, they started back-to-back. They had a makeup game with Carolina for a contest that was called due to weather earlier in the season. And they come out of the gate 2-0, the Sabres. Broken stick for Colburn, but Giroux back to support him, gets the puck. And up through center ice to Voracek. Nice hard backhand pass. Shot saved by Staloff. As that had something on it from Luke Shen. Matt Reed now over the line against Braun. Braun accelerates. So does Reed to the net. And they collide into the goalpost, knocking it off behind Staloff.
I'm going to show you the smarts of Mark-Gerhard Vlasic. Okay, you've got the broken stick, so you're going to change right here for the broken stick. And Mark-Gerhard Vlasic realizes it. He looks over. He's thinking about pressuring up here in the puck, but he changes his mind. This is a nice read. Go ahead and roll it, guys. Turns his head, says, he's going to come over on the change. They're getting possession, so he takes away any possible option for a pass for Voracek. Unfortunately, slides in a little bit deeper, but still, no harm done. No really big chance, but a good read by Mark-Gerhard Vlasic, but you'd like him just to get back up in the neutral zone and close that gap off when you get the chance.
Vlasic, one of the Sharks in on the scoring tonight with his 15th assist of the year. The Sharks' leader in points on the blue line, Jason Demers, who has two helpers in the contest tonight, and now off the faceoff when the Sharks are on the power play as Hannon's out of the box. He'll get across the ice and change as the Sharks will go on the man advantage for the third time. They're 1-for-2 with three shots. And, of course, the goal by Pavelski earlier in the period. Matt Irwin for Pavelski. He's checked by Colburn. Burns there with Pavelski. And it's intercepted by Reed, who sends it down. Sharks have caught up on the shot clock as well. It's 17-15 in favor of the Flyers. Boyle sends it in. Off the glass and around to this side. Colburn intercepts. Gives it right back to Thornton. The captain to Pavelski and the one-timer wide. Now we're back to 5-on-5. Thornton, and that ricochets to Irwin. Trickles through to Pavelski. The net, the hat trick for Joe Pavelski. And it's 5-2. And he achieves a career high, the big Pavelski's 32nd goal.
Never had a hat trick in the NHL until Tampa Bay, and now he gets his second one. Turns, fires, but the play made by Matt Irwin, keeping the puck in. Nice little play here by Irwin, under pressure, and then Joe Pavelski just turns, finds it, fires it on the net. And now 5-2, the Sharks lead with 5:50 left in the second. And Joe Pavelski.
So Joe Pavelski with career hat trick number 2. And as you said, in just this season did he score 3 goals in a game. The one in Tampa was a natural hat trick. This one, 3 goals on 4 Sharks goals. Just Logan Couture's in between prevented Pavelski from another hat trick, but he won't care about that as the puck's knocked down with a high stick. And he has 32 goals now, Pavelski, as he beats Emery on the second shot Emery faced since coming in to replace Steve Mason. The big Pavelski, a big night in Philly.
Joe Pavelski has the hat trick, and there's still 25 minutes left to play in the game. This is the one. This is the third one. Slips it underneath the pad of Ray Emery. Thanks to the play by Matt Irwin. Nice job, but a quick turnaround. No way Emery can find that puck coming off the stick. And look at the numbers, and look where Joe Pavelski is in the scoring leaders in the National Hockey League, the goal scorers.
Here's Nieto trying to center it. Prevented from doing so by Mark Streit. The Sharks scoring 4 goals in a 10-minute span here in the second period. 3 of them by Joe Pavelski. And pretty efficient work by number 8 as well. Pavelski's 3 goals on 3 shots. Nieto. And he tried to upman it for Wingles and gave it away to Mazzaros. Saved by Staloff. Now in the corner, Ronaldo leaning in. And Hannon will steer it away from trouble over to the weak side for Wingle. The communication from Jason Demers. You hear him yelling out for Scott Hannon.
Steve Downey is running around trying to get something going. He's trying to play the body on any player wearing a white jersey.
Well, don't count. You can't count Philly out. As we talked about from the get-go, there's such a good team coming from behind this year. Nobody's come from behind in the third period more than them. Well, Sharks fans, do you think what you have to take on a Sharks player and challenge them to PlayStation 4? Here's your chance. Two lucky winners and a guest will each be able to watch the Sharks morning skate before taking on Sharks players off the ice on PlayStation 4. Winners also receive a PlayStation prize package. Go to sjsharks.com/PlayStation Challenge for your chance to win. Shen up to center. Well, the Cavalier can't pick it up.
You don't want to get into this type of game where you're starting just to throw it into the neutral zone, bank it off his skates, miss a pass, and let the Flyers get their transition game going. Get back to how you were playing in this second period, getting puck deep and starting to go back to that work, that simplified game.
Braden Shen, who has one of the two Flyer goals, to his brother Luke. Now stuffed back deep by Gustafson behind the Sharks' net. And up top now, got away from Couture, sends it across, and a good stick by Matt Irwin. Gustafson holds the zone to Simmons. Wayne Simmons can't hold it as it came out over the line.
That was a really good read by Matt Irwin. He saw that Wayne Simmons was out of options as far as who he could pass the puck to, so he just pressured him up high, pushed him out of the zone.
Guided in by the Flyers, but lifted back out to Thornton at center. Joe attacking with Pavelski, and he can't settle the pass.
Just between his legs.
For Burns, though, and across and off the stick of a Flyer. That was Hartnell. Dan Boyle was hoping it would reach him. Thornton for Boyle. Shoots. Saved by Emery.
Dan Boyle getting that shot off, even though there was a stick laying on the ice. It was in his kind of his wheelhouse, but he was able to get a good shot on net.
Flyers go offside as they try and attack the San Jose zone.
How good is Joe Thornton in finding those little passes and the guy coming in at the right time? Dan Boyle jumping in. Joe Thornton gets the puck up high. What's the skip? Sitting there, he gets it in Dan Boyle's kind of way when he wants to shoot the puck, but he just relaxes for a second, lets the puck clear that stick laying on the ice, and gets a good shot on net.
Thornton with his 49th assist tonight. Second in the NHL behind Sidney Crosby, who has an assist tonight. Crosby with 51, two ahead of Thornton. The Penguins tied with Montreal 3-3 after two periods. 12 games in the NHL tonight. Here's Lasek. Plays it in. But it comes back to Couturier for the Flyers. Now Desjardins back ahead. And backhanded deep by Mike Brown. Raffy Torres on the ice. And the puck in front of the Flyers net. Picked up by Strike. He'll give it to Couturier. Across the line. Reed heads for the net. Stalock with the save. Reed trying to convert on the rebound. Good coverage though by Demers to prevent that. As Nieto comes through the middle, ran into Couturier. Mike Brown picks it up. Tries to put it on net, but it went wide off the tip. Nieto back around to the far side. Wingles comes on. He's checked by Hartnell. Burrish in the corner against Giroux, who bats it with his glove to this side. Now Burrish, but he can't settle it. Gustafson up the wing. Here comes Scott Hartnell. Trying to go all the way across for Voracek. Just too many bodies in the way. Sharks break it up. Wingles comes in with speed. On his off wing, the backhander hits the pads of Emery. A chance in front. The net teeters up and off its moorings. And a whistle to stop play.
Everybody going to the net. I like that. Jason Demers up there. Sharks forwards up there. And a good chance. Shovel towards the net with traffic getting there. How many times have we seen that so far tonight? Traffic at the net has usually ended up a good thing for the Sharks. Jason Demers and Matt Nieto with a chance. Claude Giroux puts down Matt Nieto with a hard cross check. The Sharks rush up the ice with the D jumping in. They're tough to contain.
Couture back at center on the second line. His first game back after a six-game injury layoff. He has a goal tonight, his 15th. Pavelski has three. And Torres has one himself. Sharks getting goals from three of their forward lines tonight.
And scoring five goals. That's, you know, you're getting guys back in the lineup and they produce right away. The Sharks, as we know, before the break, struggled at some times to put the puck in the net. You got also got a power play goal in that little mix.
The Cavalier lost it as it's cleared back down the ice. You were involved in a high-scoring game in Denver last night on NBC Sportsnet. Six goals by the LA Kings. They go a week sometimes without scoring that many. But they lit it up last night against Colorado.
They were happy to score three. There were some great goals in that game, too. Power plays were very important.
Now Burns drops for Pavelski, who drops for Thornton, who sends it back to the point, but nobody there in Teal.
He will change him.
Vlasic gets across in time to keep it away from Voracek. Now on the re-entry, Gustafson intercepts. He'll give it right back to Vlasic, who sends it in. Ray Emery, who came in this period to replace Steve Mason in goal when the Sharks went ahead 4-2. And now Emery surrendered one as well, the hat-trick goal to Pavelski. Final seconds here of a terrific second period for the Sharks. They've scored all the goals, all four of them. Desjardins in. Now Brown in front. Torres, he scores! Rafi Torres, his second goal of the game. And it is now 5-2 Sharks. 6-2.
Yeah.
I lost track. Six.
And this is a really smart play by Mike Brown. Put the puck on the net right now, then go back and get it. And wins the race to the puck by Gustafson, beats Drew to the post, and Rafi Torres is left alone in front again. But Mike Brown and Andrew Desjardins get the work done in the corner. Rafi Torres goes to the front of the net and finishes it off. That's a killer goal against the Flyers late in the period.
Hey, if the Kings can score six, the Sharks got to match them, right?
Absolutely.
What a second period. Ooh. Five unanswered goals as the Flyers are booed off the ice here in the city of brotherly love. That is it for the second period. I think I've got it right now. It's the Sharks six and the Flyers two. When we come back, we'll check in with Brody and Eddie in the studio, and then Drew and I will be back with Sharpshooters from Philly. Back live in Philadelphia with associate coach Larry Robinson. Larry, what was the change between period one that resulted in what happened in period two for you guys?
Well, I think we in the first period, we weren't throwing any pucks at the net. We had, I think, 17 shot attempts and only two got to the net. So that was the major difference. And I thought our forechecking was so much better that period.
Larry, you guys always kind of know what to expect in a game. But in this game, did you know what to expect after the 20-day layoff?
I mean, playing in this building, I think a long history.
Yes.
so we kind of knew what to expect, and they certainly didn't disappoint. They came at us pretty hard, and they scored those two quick goals, and then I thought we got our composure a lot better after that.
Thanks, Larry.
You're welcome.
In this building and in this city, Larry Robinson has some history.
That five-goal second period was the fifth period with five or more goals in Sharks history. It's the Sharks' biggest period since over a year ago when they scored six goals in a period at Edmonton. The Sharks had 11 players with at least a point in that period. And only four skaters right now for the Sharks don't have a shot on goal. So what a turnaround from a first period where, even though the Sharks got that first goal from Torres, they kind of stumbled after that, and Philly got those two quick ones in 22 seconds to take the lead. But terrific adjustment by everybody from coaching staff on down.
Yeah, and the big thing that Larry Robinson talked about, we've got pucks on the net.
Here's Joe Thornton trying to track down a loose puck in the Philly zone. And he's got it. Thornton rims it hard. Pass Burns behind the net, but Boyle now back for Burns, who chips it to Pavelski at the point. Pavelski to the net! And that one hit the... Or was that saved by Emery?
I think Emery got the right pad out, didn't he?
He did. Something hit it there.
Wow.
It was either Emery or the post.
Joe Pavelski shooting off the net.
Starts right off the get-go here to start the third period with another quality scoring opportunity. Well, open up this three-game and four-day road trip with a win, and they're in good shape right now, but we know how Philly can come from behind. A scramble in front of the Philadelphia net. It's cleared around by the Flyers to Downey, and he leads a 3-on-2 with Couturier. Back to Downey. Marleau back-checking, and he interferes with that shot.
The Flyers scored four goals against the Sharks the last time these guys hooked up, so you know, as you said, they can come back 10 times. They've done it this year. The Sharks have to be very aware of that. I'm sure the coaching staff reminded the Sharks that, hey, this is a team that does not quit. They keep coming at you.
Coburn across for Simmons. Irwin and Wingles, and back to Coburn again. Eric Gustafson in for Simmons. He'll lay it off for Braden Schenn. Schenn on net. Stick save by Stalock. And now Nieto punches it out to Wingles. He's in alone. And he shot it wide. Tried to pick a spot on Emery. Just missed.
Nice play by Matt Nieto.
Nice play there by Le Cavalier to chip it around Demers. But then Demers avoided taking the penalty, counting on his partner Hannon to help him out, and that's exactly what happened. They grind it out down low, and Hannon comes off the boards with the puck. He'll wrist it off for far side, taken back by the Flyers' Mark Streit. Philadelphia riding a four-game winning streak coming in. And when you're riding a streak like they were, Drew, you don't want the Olympic break, because things can change for you, as well it looks like they may have for Philadelphia here tonight.
Tommy Wingles almost makes it seven. Well, he had an opportunity to make it seven. I don't think almost was the right word, because he missed the net and rang it off the glass.
But in the first 2.5 minutes here, two quality scoring chances for the Sharks.
I want to try to put any thoughts of a comeback right out of their heads.
Mike Brown puts that one on net. Brown has 2 points in this game. Jason Demers, a couple of assists. Pavelski with the hat trick. Irwin, a point. Desjardins, an assist. Boyle's been in on the scoring. And, of course, Rafi Torres with his two. He's a goal away from three. Only has one hat trick in his NHL career. That was against one of his former teams, as a Vancouver Canuck. Torres scored three against Edmonton. That was almost 4 years ago. Well, wouldn't that be something if he can equal tonight what Pavelski did? They'll be trying to get the puck to number 13 when they can, when he's out there. Here's Burns with a steal in the neutral zone to Pavelski. Back to Burns. He shoots it off the back foot, and it deflects high and out of play. And Brent Burns is one of the few that hasn't been in on the scoring tonight, and he continues to shoot away, and that's the best thing to do when you're in a slump, but he's gone 16 in a row without a goal.
Had a great chance in the first period of pass from Martin Havlat, and has a nice little pickup there off the skate, and then that quick release of Brent Burns. It's only a matter of time. Brent Burns will get back in the scoring. He's got a great shot. He's got a nose for the net. He's a big man who knows how to get that shot off. Gets to the front of the net. Tough to move. And he's playing with Joe Pavelski and Joe Thornton.
It's not if he'll score, Drew. It's when he'll score.
It is.
Boyle. And that's just why. Classic for Pavelski. He gets a rough ride from Colburn, but keeps his feet going. Now it's cleared back out. And icing will be called here against Philadelphia.
It's interesting, too, with Joe Thornton and Brent Burns, that relationship they have. Joe Thornton takes it upon himself to not let Brent Burns get down on himself. Brent, like most terrific athletes, most high-level athletes, will put the pressure on themselves, and they'll start to really feel it, and they'll start to get down on themselves if they're not scoring. Joe Thornton is always pumping the tires of Brent Burns, loves playing with Brent Burns, loves 88 on the wing. And he knows, like you said, he'll get the puck in the net eventually again. And Joe Thornton wants to make sure he's the guy that's giving the puck to him when he does.
Irwin back. The Flyers will change on the go here as Braun gives it for Burrish, and up ahead now for Matt Nieto. A four-goal Sharks lead. Engels trying to set up Burrish in front. Here's Simmons now with speed down the wing against Irwin. And Irwin defends well. He got the arm up, I guess, and they're going to call him for the hook. That might be the hold. penalty against Matt Irwin.
Enough of an effort by Matt Irwin to disrupt Wayne Simmons from going to the puck on the forecheck. In the call of the hook, I thought maybe be a holding interference, but where's the stick come up? Oh, right at the tail end there as the stick turns in the legs.
So the power play for Philadelphia. They are 0 for 3, only two shots on their power play, which has been so good for them. Strike. Hands it off on the wing. It comes to the front now off a block. Giroux and Stalock with a nice glove save in traffic.
Did he ever make a good save? Again, able to get to a spot where he could find the puck. Find it with your eyes first. Watch his head move. Find it. See how he looked? Little right look, left look, and then he found it. Boom, got the glove up.
Pavelski stands in against Giroux for this faceoff. Pavelski with the win. Cannon will get the clear. Through two periods, Sharks were 59% in the faceoff circle. Pavelski, who just won that draw, was 67% after two. Here's Simmons on the power play. Voracek around the net to this side for Hartnell. And Wingles broke it up. And now a potential two-on-one. Here's Couture to Wingles. And he scores! Logan Couture. Great second effort. Shorthanded goal. 7-2.
Sometimes the bounces go your way. Logan Couture, two goals. Rafi Torres, two goals. Joe Pavelski, three goals. This is a nice little pass. Just a little lift. And the puck just bounces, and nobody's able to find it. Claude Giroux skates right by it. Watch, the puck's going to pop over Claude Giroux's stick. Right there. And it kind of disrupts everything. Ray Emery goes down on all fours, but the puck goes between the pads, and the Sharks lead 7-2. Wow, that's a tough goal for the Flyers to take.
That is the 10th shorthanded goal they've allowed this year. And now it's a 5-goal Sharks lead, and they have scored 6 unanswered goals in this game, the Sharks have. A slap shot from the wing by Couturier, and it'll rim all the way back into the Flyers' zone, and they have 45 seconds left on a power play that has not gone their way so far. Couture's 16th of the year. Wingles will get the lone assist.
These fans are going to get more and more upset. Braden Schenn throws the puck back, hoping the defenseman is jumping in, and went too far back into the Flyers zone.
Tommy Wingles becomes the 12th Shark skater with a point in this game.
Penalty coming
and
up.
And a penalty coming up there to Philadelphia, and Downey will sit down.
That's a tripping call. Steve Downey getting the deuce. It was a nice play by the Sharks, though, on the interchange in the corner to try to get this puck out, get possession of the puck. Nice little pick, and then Downey gets his stick in the skates of Scott Hannon. And the Sharks are going to be 4-on-4 for almost 20 more seconds.
Couture's goal is his 16th, and for Tommy Wingles, that assist gives him 31 points on the year, 19 of them helpers. And he keeps his scoring touch going back to the games before the break. Sharks on the power play. Burns in the corner. Lost control for a moment. Trying to get it back. But the Flyers will have it. Irwin out of the box. So now San Jose with the man advantage. Seven, two. Martin Havlat. And the Sharks go offside.
Timing just a little off there. Joe Thornton just ahead of the play.
Sharks power play 1-for-3 on the night. That goal belonging to Joe Pavelski, the first of his three. Torres has two. Couture has two. And the Sharks lighten up the scoreboard here in Philadelphia with 7 goals.
Well, we said we're not sure what to expect. I'm not sure any of us thought 9 goals, and certainly not 7 by the Sharks.
Torres drops for Marleau, and back to the point for Boyle. He won't take any time setting up. Takes a shot that goes wide off a tip. Good play by Grossman, but then he doesn't get it out. Marlowe trying to get it across to Thornton. That's broken up by the Flyers. Matt Reed guides it back to Grossman, and he'll wrist it all the way to Stalock, who fought it off there with Couturier right on the doorstep.
He wanted to play that up right away, and then lost his balance.
He wants a point. Trying to get an assist.
One thing you have to be 7-2, there's 12, almost 13 minutes left still, but you still have to practice those good habits and get those details in your game.
Wingles. Now the shot by Hatlatt, saved by Emery.
Like that. Pop to the outside, drive to the net, get a shot on net for a chance.
Oh, Flyers come back, and a nice chance there for Raffle.
Hook.
And another penalty as the parade to the box continues here in the third.
Justin Braun going to get the penalty. A really nice play by Raffle coming into the zone. A little toe drag. And Justin Braun arguing the call, but we're having the look at this call is going to be the stick gets parallel to the ice and on the body of the opponent. So right there. And that what Justin Braun is complaining about is that Raffle is holding his stick. But from the referee's perspective, it was the stick going parallel to the ice and horizontal on the body.
So we're back to 4-on-4 for a few seconds here. Demers, Perverish to Desjardins. And his shot knocked away by Emery with the blocker. And now Simmons comes ahead for Philadelphia. Downey steps on the ice. Philadelphia on a power play. It's Claude Giroux. Mark Streit now, number 32. Back for Giroux, the leading scorer for Philadelphia. His wrist shot gets through, same by Stalock, back to Giroux. Streit off his skate, trying to play it in front, takes a Philly bounce. Giroux off the crossbar.
He had a look, took his time, went to the wide bar, just missed.
Sharks get the clear and the line change. A minute 12. On the Philadelphia power play, but they've got a long climb back, down 7-2. Hartnell will gain the zone and get it deep. Stalock quickly to Boyle, and he'll reverse it neatly. Had to, he was under pressure, to Vlasic. And this one goes up over the far glass and out of play with just under 11 and a half left to go here in the third period.
And importantly, the faceoff comes outside. There's Mark Edward Vlasic, who played so well. He was teamed with LA Kings defenseman Drew Doughty, who had an outstanding tournament. Mark Edward Vlasic said Drew Doughty was easy to play with, fun guy to be around as well. Watched Drew Doughty last night in the LA Kings Avalanche game, as the Kings won that game. But
it's going to be weird when the Sharks play LA and they go up against one another, but well, guys seem to be able to deal with that. Here's Couture with a steal, and he scored. Well, he's got his arms up. And there's going to be a review here. Couture thinks he scored. If he did, he's got a hat trick.
You saw him nodding his head. He comes right back and looks at Dan Boyle and shakes his head. Yeah, I think that Logan Couture knows he scored the goal. Came back, quick little move. Pushes it in.
Oh, boy, it might be right on the goal line.
From the big screen that we just saw, it's going to be very, very close.
Yeah. Did it cross the line? It's going to take the overhead, and maybe even then we won't see it because of Emery Pat. Here we go.
This is the one.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's definitely it. Yep. That's a third goal. That's
a hat trick for Couture, and it's going to be 8-2.
I don't remember the last time two San Jose Sharks got a hat trick in one game.
They're still taking a look at it. There could be an issue of intent to blow the whistle here, but that didn't seem to be the call on the ice.
Like the case. It's interesting that Logan Couture gets right over there where Steve Coates is doing the good work down there for the Philadelphia Flyers. He's got the monitor, and Logan Couture was looking at it. And I think Logan looks like, when you look at this one right here, this definitely goes in to me. Just as the puck starts to move.
Yep, there's daylight.
Right there,
for sure.
It's across the goal line.
Yeah.
Right there, it's across the goal line. Then it comes back out. If you keep that going, I even think when the Flyers come to try to fish it out, I think it goes back in.
It sure looks good from here.
Yeah, it looks like a good goal to me.
They're looking at it in Toronto. Video goal judge here conferenced in as well. That is referee Chris Rooney on the headset. We're just waiting to find out if the Sharks have a 6-goal lead or it stays at 5. It would also be a second shorthanded goal tonight.
Right. Well, they're looking at it, so they're taking their time in the situation room. They want to get the call right.
And there are other angles on the Philadelphia telecast on Comcast Sportsnet Philadelphia.
I love the fact Logan's watching down by the ice. One more time. Let's go have a look at it. Quick move by Logan Couture. That's where I think he gets in. Logan doesn't miss very often. He knows. He reads the game very well. Gets his hands up. This is the one where I think it's definitive, where you see the puck is definitely going past the goal line. It's in right there.
Yeah.
It's in past the goal line. And to me, that looks like it's a goal. Logan's discussing it with Coatsy. I think Coatsy was lobbying. That's a great look right there.
There was a comment there.
Yeah, Logan just turned, looked at the bench and said, you saw this much daylight, you know, put his thumb on his forefinger, a little squeezed him apart and said, yeah, about that much. It's been by about that much.
Well, has there ever been more intrigue about an eighth goal?
8-2 goal. The Flyers fans are starting to booze, are starting to rain down, but Logan has got the smile and he says, come on. No, well now he's shaking his head. No, he's not sure now. He thinks maybe he's taking the time. He's not sure. But I think right away when he skated out towards Dan Boyle and nodded up and down, he definitely believes it crossed the goal line. Now he's wondering if he'll get the call go his way. But to me, it looked like it crossed the goal line on that overhead.
Well, just the geometry of the width of the puck and the amount alongside the in part of the net that it was would suggest that it was in, and not suggest, it looked in.
Now they are taking their time here, which is great.
It's fine.
It's what you want. Now the Flyers fans don't like it.
Well, they might not like it because they probably want this to end.
Yeah, so 11 minutes and 11 seconds left. Let's go one more time. Let's look. You already know what I think. I think right there, as it comes back, it just freeze it there, guys, keep it there. Because the puck comes back and hits that part of the pad of Ray Emery, and that pad's that pad where it goes down to the foot and then kicks back out, that part is already in the net. And so the puck goes in and bounces off of that and kicks back out past the goal line. That's why I think it's a goal.
Now some guys are coming off the bench and skating to keep their legs warm. Rafi Torres out there taking a twirl. Mike Brown taking a twirl. Guys don't want to get stiff sitting on the bench. They want to keep playing here, but with this long delay, it's tough.
Logan's still looking at it, and he's looking at the Flyers. They have a different camera and a different angle than we do on it. And I love the fact that Logan's over there. He is a student of the game. That's the one thing about Logan Couture.
I guess it would be easy with San Jose holding a 5-goal lead to say, all right, it's not a goal, but it's got to be the right call, and they're doing the right thing.
It's one or the other, and they could do the easy thing. Here's the zoomed in look, right there.
Yeah, that's when it bounces off the in pad. Yeah. There it's in.
When it bounces off of freeze it, guys. When it bounces off of that part, right there. Yep, go ahead.
It's past the goal line.
It's past the goal line. Right there, it bounces off that part, past the goal line. And I think it's in. I think it's a goal. But I've already said that a couple of times.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we'll see what the NHL Situation Room comes up with. Often called the War Room, not the War Room, Randy.
No, the Situation Room,
because situations arise all the time in a hockey game.
And we're not at war.
No.
Here's the call. Let's listen.
No ball.
All right. So they've disallowed it. I guess the view we had was not conclusive enough for the Situation Room. So Couture, at least for now, denied a hat trick, but the Sharks still have a 7-2 lead.
And the thing is, there was no call on the ice. And oftentimes, the referees do that because they don't know. So the call was up to the... There wasn't a definitive answer of yes or no. Did the puck cross the line? The only thing the Situation Room looked at is, in their view, to definitively cross the line, and I guess not according to them.
So the Flyers still on the power play. But rather than being their strength tonight, it has been the opposite of that, as they've given up one shorthanded goal and almost two.
Ray Emery stops that long bank clear by the Sharks off the boards, and the crowd gives them a little bit of a Is it a Bronx cheer in Philly? Can you give a call to the Bronx cheer in Philly?
No, that would be a derisive cheer.
Yes, it would be very good.
Reed across. Power play over. Sharks back at full strength. And now Braden Schenn. Schenn turning. Back to Colburn. Knocked down by Stalock. And Demers will clear it through center and down the ice. Patrick Marleau in a race with Colburn, but they had washed out the icing call prior to that. 7-2 with under half a period left here in the third. Ray Emery came in at 4-2, and he's given up three after Steve Mason gave up those first four to the Sharks. Luke Schenn gets it deep. Burns gets it out from behind the net. Kept in by Gustafson. Saved by Stalock. And a nice stop it was again through all kinds of traffic. Here's Voracek for Philadelphia. He gets it back to Gustafson. Accelerating. The back pass. Raffle tipped and saved by Stalock. And another strong stop by Alex Stalock, who's still playing tremendous goal, even though it's a one-sided affair. Back in Philadelphia, where it's time for our Coors Light Cold Hard Facts, a list of goal scorers on the road since the start of the 2010-2011 season. Alex Ovechkin, number one, followed by Corey Perry, Steven Stamkos, and then Logan Couture, who has 60 road goals for the San Jose Sharks since the start of that 2010 season. He almost had his 61st.
Almost had his 61st, but the situation room in Toronto could not clearly decide. Well, they did decide that the puck did not cross the line because they just could not tell because of the snow buildup, and we've got a goalie change again.
The Flyers did not dress three goalies.
No.
Steve Mason's back in goal. He's going to give it a second go. Here's Wingle. To Braun. Back across, he wanted Nieto. Wingles to Irwin. He misfires. Braun control, shoots, and it's high over the glove of Mason.
Stick just snapped on Matt Irwin. Couldn't get that big shot off.
Now Wingles leaves it for Nieto. And he'll throw one wide. Desjardins on the far boards. Picked up by Mazaros. Now a chance and a shot wide of the net comes to Demers at the right point. He'll send it up the boards and all the way through to Mike Brown behind the Philly goal, and he wanted to hit. Rafi Torres coming down that side in stride. Now the Sharks attack on a bad change by Philly. Torres to the net and just wide.
Four just wide.
Brown pushed off the puck. And now Matt Reed for Philadelphia. Here's Couturier, and they score! Matt Reed, and that ends the string of six straight goals by the Sharks. Makes it 7-3.
I usually don't tell a straight on goals, but I'm going to show you this one. Watch Rafi Torres coming back here. See him shaking his leg? He's a little tired, gets his feet planted. That's his guy. Gets on the wrong side because he did not come back hard. You see his reaction after. He talked to us at the end of the first period that he got overextended in the first period on the one goal. Overextended on the shift. Right there, he did the same thing, and it cost him.
So a two-goal swing for Philly on the disallowed goal by Couture, and then Reed just scoring his 16th of the season. And that makes it a four-goal game now, 7-3, with 7:35 left in the third.
There's still 7:35 left. And listen, I'm not a pessimist, but I was an ex-coach, so this is the way coaches think. You don't ever want to give anything to the other team, to give them a thought process that they got a chance to come back in the game. So if you can, right now you're the Sharks, you want to make sure you do everything you can to take the momentum away from the Flyers.
Technically, and not to be picky, you weren't an ex-coach. You are one.
I am an ex-coach. That's true. Although my ball hockey career is really thriving right now.
It's flourishing.
In the Saskatoon Ball Hockey League. coaching my kids.
Reed from Couturier and Grossman at 12-12. The goal to make it 7-3 here in Philadelphia. Wild night. We've got a 10-goal game and counting. And the Flyers have been going back and forth with goaltenders. Only two Sharks don't have a shot on goal in this game. Joe Thornton, which is not a bulletin, and Scott Hannon. Al Marlowe with a steal at center, comes across the line with Martin Havlat. Havlat trying to get it back for Patrick, broken up by Luke Shen. Now Havlat behind the net, can't catch the pass. Coming across is Couture, and he gets position on Simmons, but Ronaldo is able to clear it up and out of the zone. 6.5 left here in the third. Sharks can roll the lines, and that'll help a little bit for the game tomorrow night in Buffalo. Don't have to overwork anybody.
It certainly does. You want to make sure the guys get their ice time in.
Ronaldo and a glove save by Stalock. And that is the 28th shot of the game by Philadelphia, but they trail the Sharks 7-3. The Sharks trailed in this game, believe it or not, 2-1 after the first period. Then Joe Pavelski says, I'll fix that. Scores his 30th. Then 31st to tie a career high. Logan Couture scored a goal, and then Pavelski said, I'm not done yet. And he turns and fires and scores his career high 32nd goal. His second career hat trick, both of them this season, charged with three players, Pavelski, Couture, and Torres, with multiple goal games here in Philadelphia tonight.
Those three goals move Joe Pavelski second in scoring, goal scoring in the National Hockey League.
Here's Mazzaros with room, time, and a backhand saved by Stalock. Well, that's the second time tonight Mazzaros has walked in down that side.
Good player, isn't he? Very crafty with the puck.
Burrish for Nieto, and now Wingles after it in the corner. Here's Hartnell across for Voracek. Irwin back with Braun defensively. Voracek loads up, and Stalock, a great save. And boy, has he been good in a game that sometimes when you're this far ahead, you might lose your focus. He hasn't.
Get 30 shots on him. That's a lot of shots to give up. And Alex Stalock, a couple of good saves. This is a good one right here. Ready, set, fights it off, finds it, and look at how he follows it with the eyes, even when it goes up over into the netting. And the Sharks have given up three dynamite chances. One's a goal, and two for really good saves by Alex Stalock.
27 saves for Alex Stalock, who got the start ahead of Antti Niemi tonight. And he's making the best of it here, but he certainly had the run support down at the other end, hasn't he? Thornton now holds off against Colburn. Runs into Grossman, still battling away as Joe.
The kind of shifts you need right now, some of the work down low.
Turned over by the Flyers and fired right back in for Pavelski now. Colburn able to kick it away from Pavelski. Thornton comes across. And now the Flyers come ahead, 2-on-2. Boyle back, he'll get to this ahead of Reed and send it back the other way. Join us at 3:30 Pacific tomorrow for Sharks pregame live from Buffalo, then the Sharks and the Sabres at 4. Sunday, game time noon Pacific from New Jersey. Classic shot kicked out by the Flyers netminder. Now it is Havlat back down the boards. Sharks attacking again. Marlowe, Couture, saved by Mason. And cleared back out by the Flyers.
Wow, rebound's right there, though, isn't it? Well, not a very hard shot. Logan had to fight to get the shot off. But still, the rebound got kicked right out to the middle.
Time down to 4 and change here in the third. Sharks with a 4-goal lead. Irwin gets it flat. About half the crowd left here at the Wells Fargo Center. Early arriving, but early leaving because of what happened in the second period and into the third with the Sharks scoring 6 in a row. A little teal in the crowd here tonight as Sharks fans representing here on the East Coast.
Good representation of Sharks fans. They were hanging over the railings as the Sharks came out for warm-up, and you see the Flyer fans start to leave. a faithful lot, but it's 7-3 with less than 4 minutes left. They try to get out of the parking lot as quickly as you can.
And the Sharks in pretty good shape here to split their season series with the Flyers. And this doesn't erase the 5-2 loss at home to Philadelphia, but makes you feel a little bit better as you come back and rally around in this first game back after the Olympics to make some amends for that, well, arguably poorest home performance of the year.
You know, you just don't know what you're going to get when you've got 20 days off and you've got some guys who went and played in a huge tournament, and then you've got other guys who went on vacation and took some time off and you didn't get practicing together and you met all on the road. It's, you never know what's going to happen with your team. I know that Todd McClellan was unsure how his team was going to play in this game, but you want to see them finish off strong with good habits.
Chasing back is Grossman for Philadelphia. Flyers, despite this loss, will certainly stay in the hunt in the Eastern Conference playoff race, but this will be a little bit of a sobering experience for them and a tough way to end their four-game winning streak. We'll be back.
Hi, everybody. I'm Dave Feldman. Coming up on Sportsnet Central at 10:30, much more on the offensive explosion by the Sharks in Philadelphia. Is Mark Davis really threatening to move the Raiders? He's got some strong words for the city of Oakland. And one-on-one with the A's, Jesse Chavez. All that and more on Sportsnet Central at 10:30. Let's go back to the guys and the ice in Philadelphia.
Well, here in Philly, Joe Pavelski has a hat trick, but two Sharks players with a pair of goals each. Rafi Torres and that man, Logan Couture. Torres scored the first goal of this game in his first game of the season. About 4.5 minutes in, great work by his line mate, Mike Brown. And then the shot by Jason Demers there for Torres to pounce on and put home for goal number one of the year. Logan Couture would score in his first game back, as well as you saw Torres' second goal there. Logan's coming when the Sharks were ahead 3-2, and that would be a big one as well. As Couture has a pair. Dan Boyle clearing it out. As Coburn's back, and we're down to 2.5 minutes left in this one. You want to say an unlikely outcome here, but again, when you go back to really all the talk and the buildup leading to this game, you just didn't know what to expect. Thornton can't reach that pass, and Mason will put his glove over top of it to stop the clock.
Ooh, Scott Hartnell went right back at Mark Edward Vlasic in the neutral zone. Mark Edward Vlasic draws the ire of the Flyers number 19 for check late in the zone of the Sharks. Mark Edward Vlasic just turns away.
Hartnell goes off the ice as he got a penalty. So much for unity among Canadian players coming out of the Olympics.
Nope. It's funny how it automatically just changes, right? Just boom, you're back into it. Now you're going. Hartnell took a shot just to try to finish a check at Mark Edward Vlasic in the defensive zone. Vlasic gave him a little bit of a chop as they were coming back out of the zone.
So now Rafi Torres out on the power play. He's sitting on two goals. And of course, we'll also see Logan Couture on this power play. Enough time on the clock for the Sharks to run the whole two-minute drill here. Not that they need more goals, but wouldn't that be something if Rafi Torres got one here? Power play Sharks. They're 1-for-4. There's Torres in the corner, but it comes out to Couturier for Philadelphia. And he'll dump it into the corner. Dan Boyle takes a look. Torres goes off the ice. And Matt Nieto comes on in his spot. Adam Burrish out there as well, as Brown can't get the puck in. Dumped back down by Couturier. So Todd McClellan giving some players power play opportunities that they normally wouldn't see in a game that is not as lopsided as this one. Wingles fans, there's a shot by Boyle, and that went just over the net.
As you said, there's a guy that could use a goal as well, Dan Boyle. That one just couldn't get it down on net.
That was Adam Hall firing it to the net. Adam Burrish now with a minute left to Wingles. Demers, he'll shoot it. Save. By Mason, back to Nieto again. Demers, across and to Wingles and to the middle, and it hit Grossman. Burris to Braun. Braun to the net, but wide. Demers able to hold the zone. Wingles turns and tries to get over to Nieto, but it deflects up and out of play. Off the stick of a Flyer, and we are down to the final half minute of this one.
Let's go.
Hartnell also got a misconduct here,
yeah,
didn't he?
It's go ahead. Just to, here's Scott Hartnell right here. Now just watch as this thing exchanges. Here's the shot at Mark-Edward Vlasic. The slash back, the big chop right there by Scott Hartnell, and the play went back in the neutral zone. There's another little jab of the stick by Scott Hartnell. That's why he was sent to the showers early.
So 2 and 10 for Hartnell, for what it's worth. Just adding to the penalty minute totals for the Flyers, the most penalized team in the NHL. Although that wasn't really their undoing in this game.
No.
Just one power play goal scored by the Sharks. Brown fighting for it here in the dying seconds. Torres, he takes a hit from Shen, and that's your hockey game. And the San Jose Sharks explode out of the gates post-Olympic Games as they get 7 goals, a hat trick from Pavelski, 2 each from Torres and Couture, and they blow the Flyers out here at Wells Fargo Center. The final score, the Sharks 7, Philadelphia 3. Sharks post-game live starts now.